Assalamualaikum and hello. In this video, I'm going to continue about two major factors affecting the size of atom in the periodic table. So basically, there are two major factors yang akan affect size of atom. So dalam kes ini, factor yang pertama is effective nuclear charge. The name is very long, but you have to write it down as full as it is. And symbol for effective nuclear charge is ZEFF, but I always pronounce it as ZEF. And how you want to determine the effective nuclear charge for different elements, there is a specific formula how you want to calculate ZEF, which is ZEF equals to Z minus S, capital S. And the Z here is referring to the proton number, and S here is referring to the number of electrons in inner shells. So how you want to know the number of electrons in inner shell? What you have to know that the valence electron first. So you all understand the valence electrons adalah electrons yang paling luar ataupun yang paling jauh daripada nukleus, berada dalam shell yang paling luar. So sekiranya awak boleh tentukan valence electrons, so nilai valence electrons tu awak akan tolak dengan proton number, selebihnya itulah yang akan jadi inner electrons. Settle for the first factor. Dan sekarang kita go to the second factor, iaitu shielding effect, ataupun nama lain dia adalah screening effect. So itu adalah faktor yang kita akan fokus dalam subtopik kali ini. Now, berdasarkan faktor yang pertama, ZEF. So what is that actually? So ZEF is a net positive charge of a valence electrons experience as a result shielding effects by the inner electrons from the nucleus. So maksudnya, apabila inner electrons menghalang valence electrons untuk dekat dengan nukleus, daripada situasi tersebut, nilai positif akan diperolehi, di mana nilai positif charge itu adalah ZEF. And then apa yang awak perlu faham juga, electrons moving around the nucleus dan dia takkan mengalami same nucleus attraction. Maknanya, lain electron, lain nucleus attractions dia. Contohnya, electrons closer to the nucleus akan experience daya tarikan yang lebih kuat. Sekiranya electron yang jauh daripada nucleus, dia akan mengalami daya tarikan yang lemah. Kenapa apabila electrons closer to the nucleus will have greater nucleus attraction? This is because electrons, the charge is negative. And the nucleus, the charge is positive because there are neutrons dan juga proton number. Neutrons, zero value. Proton, always positive. So that's why dalam nucleus kita tahu charge dia adalah positive. Electrons, charge dia adalah negative. So opposite charge akan menarik. So that's why kalau dekat awak punya opposite charge, dia akan menarik dengan kuat. Sekiranya jauh opposite charges awak, dia akan mengalami daya tarikan yang lemah. And then, the next one, how you want to calculate the effective nuclear charge yang kita faham sebagai positive charge felt by an electron. So, as I mentioned before, we got this formula. And as you can see here, the higher the value of ZEF, the stronger the nucleus attraction toward valence electron. So macam mana kita nak kira? Ingat, Z you can obtain the value from the table RAM. S, these are the number of inner electrons. So this is what you should determine from electronic configuration. So for example, I got this question. Consider you have lithium atom. So you want to know what is the ZEF ataupun positive charge felt by electron in lithium. So macam mana kita nak tentukan that value? First, Benda pertama, always write the electronic configuration. So lithium has 3 proton number. So of course, 3 electrons due to neutral atom. So we will have the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s1. Okay, kena tulis electronic configuration dahulu. And the next one, apa yang kita tahu, the proton number for lithium is 3. How you want to determine the number of inner electrons? So the number of inner electrons adalah based on the valence electrons. So as you see here, the valence electrons adalah 1 yang berada dalam subshell 2s. So this is the valence electrons. So macam mana kita nak tentukan number of inner electrons? Number of inner electrons adalah electron yang selebihnya, bukan valence electron. Dan apa yang kita ada hanyalah electrons dalam 1s orbital. So that's why it's going to be 2 for the number of inner electrons. Therefore, how you want to calculate ZEV? ZEV equals to proton number, which is 3, minus 2 from your number of inner electrons. So you will have positive 1. Okay, wajib tulis positive 1. Positive dekat depan ni, wajib tulis sign. Sebab dia mewakili positive charge felt by an electron. Ini adalah effective nuclear charge. So, bukan saya sahaja letak sahaja, wajib tulis. And then, how you want to conclude that? You can conclude as ZEV experienced by 2s electron. So, maknanya electron dalam valence shell is only positive 1. So, inilah apa yang saya maksudkan dengan effective nuclear charge. Okay, let's try one more example. I have aluminium atom. So, aluminium, the proton number is 13. So, what we're gonna do, first thing first, as usual, write the electronic configuration. So, you will have this as your EC, electronic configuration. And how many proton number you have for aluminium is 13. And the number of inner electrons, macam biasa, tentukan valence shell dahulu. So, valence shell adalah N yang paling tinggi, iaitu N equals to 3. So, N equals to 3, kita punya 2 subshell dekat sini, subshell 3S dan juga subshell 3P. So, maknanya semua electrons dalam subshell yang saya highlight ini adalah valence electrons. So, kita nak tentukan number of inner electrons, maknanya yang berada di hadapan ni. So, this is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 sebanyak 10 electrons. Then, how can we calculate the ZEV? It's going to be 13 minus 10. So, you will have the value for ZEV is positive 3. So, what can you conclude here? ZEV experienced by 3s dan 3p. Sebab siapa yang mengalami ZEV adalah valence electron. So, 3s and 3p electron experience ZEV as positive 3. And you have to remember that ZEV value always positive. It cannot be negative. Okay? So, that's it for the example of effective nuclear charge. For the next one, we are going to focus about shielding effect. So, shielding effect depends on the value of the principal quantum number of the valence electron. Maknanya, you have to know the VEC for your any elements given. And after that, awak akan lihat value untuk principal quantum number. Iaitu dalam case ini adalah value for N. Okay? And the next one, macam mana kita nak faham beza antara shielding effect dengan ZEV? Sebenarnya dia ada perkaitan sedikit, tapi saya boleh explain. Untuk ZEV, we can calculate the value for ZEV. And there is a specific formula for ZEV. But for shielding effect, is just a effect. Kejadian yang berlaku dalam atom. Then, shielding effect happen or caused by electrons in inner shell shielding the electrons in outer shells from the nucleus. Maksudnya, I use this picture, I have nucleus here, and then I got the n equals to 1. So, ini shell yang pertama. And I got n equals to 2. This is the second shell. And then, as you see here, I got electrons in n equals to 1. And saya juga ada electrons in n equals to 2. So, macam mana saya nak explain how the shielding effect happen? Shielding effect berlaku apabila inner electrons dalam n equals to 1 menghalang electrons daripada valence shell n equals to 2 untuk dekat kepada nucleus. Berlakulah shielding effect antara nucleus dengan valence electron hasil daripada halangan inner electrons. Then you have to know that it also occurs between electrons in the same shell but less effective. Maknanya, electrons yang berada dalam shell yang sama akan ada repulsion juga. Dia akan ada shielding effect juga dekat dalam shell yang sama between those electrons, tapi dia kurang efektif dan kurang significant. That's why we are not going to focus for that part. Kita hanya fokus antara valence electrons dengan nucleus. So you will always hear my term about attraction between nucleus and valence electrons. For example, kita ada dua contoh. I got sodium and I got potassium. How strong the value of the principal quantum number of the valence electrons can influence the shielding effect for that atom. So, as you see here, I got two different atoms, sodium and potassium. Kalau saya draw dalam bentuk cara yang awak draw waktu zaman awak SPM, I got the diagram like this and I got the diagram like this. Okay, it's much more easier to explain the shielding effect. As you see here, shielding effect for the valence electrons of Na is less than K. Kerana apa? Kerana Na mempunyai inner electrons yang lagi rendah daripada K. So that's why bila N awak increases, shielding effect also increases. Seperti mana shielding effect tu bergantung kepada highest value of N. So as you see here, Na mempunyai N value yang paling tinggi adalah N equals to 3. And K mempunyai N yang paling tinggi, N equals to 4. So, this one much more higher. That's why shielding effect for K is higher than sodium. Apart from that, I can also explain that there are 10 inner electrons in Na. Only one valence electron. And here, I got 18 inner electrons in potassium. So, antara 10 inner electron dengan 18 inner electrons, yang mana lebih ramai yang menghalang untuk valence electron lebih dekat kepada nukleus adalah untuk atom K. So, itulah yang dimaksudkan dengan shielding effect. And please remember, dua faktor yang awak belajar dalam awak punya video ini akan menentukan sejauh mana awak faham the variation in atomic radii dalam video-video yang seterusnya. So, that's it for this video. I just want you to understand between these two major factors yang kita akan selalu dengar dan akan selalu guna dalam video yang seterusnya. So, I hope you understood the difference between effective nuclear charge ZEV dan juga shielding effect. So, for the next video, we are going to learn how to determine the atomic radii across the period and also down the group. So, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.